Hey guys, Brian Neely here from Art of Airbrush. Just wanted to show you guys what the shop's about. So I had another long night of painting, and wanted to give you guys a walkthrough on what's going on with the store. So the mall's all closed up right now. So it's about 2 o'clock in the morning. But give everybody a feel for what we have in the store and whatnot. So when you walk in, right there on the left-hand side is the flip rack. And then following right up with it is the counter with the work area and the easel and whatnot. We try and always have an impact item on display. Say right now it's Christmas season, so obviously stockings are there. And say normally this thing is full, but these people have been wiping me out lately with these. So, but then off to the right, for the Christmas season, just a way for us to get customers in the store, we offered to become the Toys for Tots drop location. So they've kind of followed up with it every year from now on out. But coming into the store, though, we have our impact area. Looks like the kiddies have been getting a hold of the helmets and stuff again. But some of the basic designs, sports designs, and school-related stuff. Underneath that, we've got some of our merchandise and whatnot, just different colored shirts. We get a lot of people that don't like white t-shirts, so lots of different colored stuff. Say, then on to the next section, trucker hats, flat builds. So those are really big sellers right now. On to some more popular designs. This used to be our top 50, but we've kind of shrunk it down. So it's probably top, let's say 16, 17. I can't remember how many's on the wall right there. But popular designs, these all sell. I'd say I sell at least one design out of this section almost every single day. Another thing we've incorporated in our store is black designs on black. So if you guys haven't put this up, I would definitely do it. It's a great upsell. You'll get a lot of people that are really opposed to putting stuff on white, or they don't want to put it on a color, garment or whatnot. So you can offer it to them on black. You double that price point on there. You know, it takes you a little bit longer, but you just went from a $15 sale to a $30 sale. And you know, if you've got the right kind of paints and whatnot, and you know how to paint on black, you can really whip this stuff out pretty fast. Moving on to the next section, though. Couples designs. We've got 11 designs out. Say we've went through, and over the last few years, we kind of know what sells and what doesn't, so we've put the more popular ones out, and we'll point people in the right direction. Coming back to the next section, though, we've got license plates right here on the rack. And we've incorporated a t-shirt up there, just to kind of mix it up. But basic license plates, we keep these things pretty simple. It's very tedious to paint these, and you know, if the price point's more than 15 to 25 bucks, most people don't want to pay for something like that. So that's most of our basic license plate designs. Coming over to the kids section, still got a few of Pat's designs out. The horse one's a really good seller, along with the cat. You know, the baby one, we've kind of taken that and made it our own and changed it to a funny catchphrase, and just other designs that we found that have worked well. But the same idea as the rest of the store, though. We've got colored garments, you know, onesies, bibs. We've incorporated different items and whatnot, not just t-shirts. So coming back to the kids rack, and above on almost all the racks we have a display piece that basically breaks down exact price points on how much the t-shirt is. You know, the artwork is sold separately. Moving on, we've got the fitting rooms right there. We've got crap just overflowing. We've got so much stuff going on in the store right now. So we've got shirt orders and stuff to put away. But back to the memorial section. This is a big, big section for us. I mean, I reference this all the time. That's all I've painted mostly today is memorial stuff. So if you guys don't have a dedicated memorial section in your shop, we strongly suggest that you put it up. coming on over to where the heat press and stuff is at. Keep a lot of extra parts and stuff back here, tapes, mall hours. And we've got our drawers here where we keep all of our clips and whatnot, extra spare airbrushes. And we've got our counter with all of our work and stuff on it. And this is our done rack and our to-do rack and whatnot, so we know what we have to do when we come in. Organization is key. We don't want to spend forever trying to figure out what's going on. So, cutting mat, it's good to have when you're making your own stencils and whatnot. A filing cabinet, this is a big one. For you new guys, you know, keeping stuff separated and your designs easy to find is a big one. So go through and label them, you know. The designs around the store, you've got number 22, boom, you pull it out. You got stencil number 22, you're not searching for 20 minutes for a flower design that you can't find or whatnot. So it's good to keep organized and whatnot. Some other key things, soda pop. Everybody needs soda, especially at 2 o'clock in the morning. Yes, it's late. But cash register, that's a big one. Take credit cards. It will really scare people off if you don't take credit cards. It makes your business seem almost not professional. So even for people that travel on the road and whatnot, definitely get into finding where you can get the square to attach your Android or your iPhone or whatnot. Having a computer is really handy for photo transfers and whatnot. Again, you know, we pick this stuff up at Staples when we run out, but Airwaves is a really good site to get transfer paper from. I'll go ahead and throw the link on there. But we print everything with a standard printer, HP. I mean, we go through a couple printers a year. We burn through ink cartridges like it's nobody's business. I mean, that's 1 week's worth of ink cartridges. So if you can find a printer that you can fill up your own toner, definitely do it. It's a wise investment. We're definitely looking into it and whatnot. So, but I mean, that's pretty much the gist of the store. Look at me now, how? Look at me now, yeah. I'm fresher than